Hey guys, welcome back to this channel. So today I'll be doing a sketchbook tour, and it's sort of a different sketchbook tour. I have really rough sketches in this, but I really wanted to share this because you should know that every artist has a really rough sketch, like a sketchbook in which he or she does any sort of stuff. So don't be scared to share your sketchbook out there in the world. So yeah, let's begin. So I actually DIY'd this sketchbook. I made it out of 100 GSM paper which I bought. It was a JK Cedar paper. I would link it down below if you want to know which paper I used inside. And this paper is actually the cutout of a file, an old file which I used, and I just renovated it and I drew on it. So yeah, I just named the sketchbook as Face. So this first sketchbook I was really inspired by some of the Pinterest photos, room decor photos, and this fiddle leaf fig tree was one of the very famous plants which I came across. So yeah, and this is actually a seagrass basket. It's quite famous in the plant community. And yeah, so I just So in this sketchbook I've done mostly art journaling, so you'll see a lot of that in this. And I wanted to write dates for all of these, but I forgot somehow. So most of the drawings don't have dates on this. So this is actually a planter, a bamboo planter, bamboo cut out into a planter. So you can actually get ideas from this sketchbook as to what sort of DIYs you can do. And here is another page. So this is actually my dream room decor thing which I want to do maybe sometime else, like in the future. For now I just painted the kind of a room decor which I want. So in any given moment we have two options: to step forward into the growth or back into safety. So I did take inspiration from Pinterest a lot. So here, so these are some random characters. This one is Oddish, which you remember from Pokemon. It's not the same, it's a bit different, but yeah. And some of the characters came into my mind, I don't know, from nowhere. So this is a plant, a panda plant. It's really cute, succulent. And but I really am really bad at succulent care, so yeah, maybe that's the reason why I drew it. So this one was actually a live reference drawing. I actually saw this tree. This tree is actually in front of my house and it's quite bushy, so I made it sparse because so that it could look haunted sort of. So this sketch is actually made out of micron pen or ballpoint pen. Yeah, I have used ballpoint pen in the fine lines. That Liko Feku pen you have, that is the best pen you can come across, according to me. Liko Feku pen, like use and throw pen. You can search it on Amazon. You will get it very easily and for very cheap. And this one is I don't know from where. I think from an art gallery. I took an inspiration for this one. This one is the backyard of my house. It looks a little messed up, but that's okay. I was trying out something new, drawing from live things, and I really like the color, how it turned out. And you can see the color. This is actually Camlin Artist watercolor, so trust me on that when I say Camlin Artist watercolor is the best. And yeah, I don't know why there's a craze of using foreign winter Winsor & Newton, but I think Camlin Artist watercolor does the job really well. Here, this is again another flower that bloomed. It was, I think I drew it on 16th March. You can see how old this sketchbook is, and I was not consistent with drawing on paper. I mostly draw digitally nowadays because I got a Procreate, but it's a good habit to keep a sketchbook. So I would encourage you guys to keep a sketchbook. It really improves your drawing skills. So this one is again a random abstract artwork which I felt like doing someday, and I've used really earthy tones like dusky pink color. This I made using by mixing pink along with burnt sienna. Yeah, and I really like the way this page looks. And then again, this is I would say another quote. You'll see a lot of quotes from here onwards. So, and here's the minimalist quote: life is like a cup of tea, it's all in how you make it. And again, so these paper, brown paper, you'll get it in your Amazon packaging, or this brown bag is really easily available, and I tore it off and I wrote quotes on it. So yeah, all the quotes which I've like taken reference from, I've written the names. So you can pause and read it if you want to. I won't be reading it for you. And these washi tapes, I did do a haul on these. I think I bought it from a local shop. These are actually very sparkly and silvery, and yeah, I really like them. So yeah, these are some random pages again. This was actually a messed up page, so I wanted to correct this, so I added torn up pages and added quotes to it. So it's a really nice way to patch up your sketchbook. You can add quotes, you can just cover it with paint. And then here again, this was a really messed up thing. This moon, it did not come out the way I wanted to come out, because I did use a torn up page and I tried drawing over it with white pencil, but it did not turn out to be the way I wanted it to be. So yeah, this page is messed up, so just don't look at that. So you are doing peachy. I wanted to make a sort of a pattern page, and I really like the way watercolors has worked in this one. And then I turned him into art when he was merely an empty canvas, and I really like the way the eyes have come out. I think it took me half an hour, I think, yeah, to just make it the way I wanted to look, like the way I had imagined it. So again, this proverb is from somewhere, so I just quoted it. And this is a honeybee and lavender field. And then here again, a quote. This quote is really common, I've seen it often, a lot. And this one is actually, I copied it from Pinterest. I am, if you know the artist, whoever has done this, I was just wanting to take inspiration from Pinterest, so I just made it. I wanted to scribble a lot, and I wanted to scribble in a nice manner, so I just found this one and I scribbled off something. So this one, so all the quotes here are made up, like I made it up, and I randomly made patterns. So these are not all of my own creation, out of my own creation. So whichever I have taken inspiration from Pinterest, I'll tell you. And yeah, so I really like the feel of it, this black and white picture. And here again, I wanted to paint something modern, and I was really inspired by some of the room decors, the minimalist room decors on Pinterest. So I just, and here I was really having fun, I just painted off my hand and stuck it in this page, and drew some flowers and wrote a quote. So you can do random stuff on a sketchbook, you don't have to be very precise. So this is just a lighthouse, nothing fancy. And here, this was actually, I got it out of a cloth I bought, and I just pasted it and drew a like a parachute thing, imagining this one to be parachute. And then you can see I added some quotes, travel quotes, because it's a parachute, so it will travel. Then here again, you belong among the wildflowers, and here I drew some flowers, and I tore up pages from magazines, and and this girl also, I tore it off some magazine. Isn't it funny how day by day nothing changes, but when you look back, everything is different. C.S. Lewis. So I really like some of the quotes. I wanted to keep them in a journal, and I did that by art journaling. It's a really nice way of keeping your sketchbook fun and lively. And I just wanted to try art journaling because it's something out of my comfort zone. I've never done it. This is the first time, and I feel really good about it. Actually, nothing feels better than laughing together with your best friend. Best cooked foods are often homemade, and best cook would always be mom. So this actually picture reminded me of my mom, and I just wanted to make this, like, quote this. These two quotes are made by me. So this you'll always hear from some or the other people. I don't know why I added this quote here, but I felt like adding it. So yeah, again, some random pictures with brown pages, and I tore it with my hand, so it was all the more authentic and it looked really organic. And here I wrote some stuff. If you want to read it, you can pause it and read it, but there's nothing much. So I guess this is the end of the book. And yeah, if you want to read all the stuff, you can pause and read all the written stuff, but I think that's the end of the book. So these are signs. You can get it off my website, art website, and these are nothing but pages, like torn out pages. So yeah, that was the end of my sketchbook tour. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope it was something you guys would try out or doing in your sketchbook. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, have a nice day.